Okay, in this example, we're going to use Excel to create a frequency table, relative frequency table for the data that is appearing here in column A of the spreadsheet. And then we're going to create a frequency histogram. So you can see we've got a list of values here in column A. It looks like our sample size is 40. So we've got 40 entries in there, and they're not in order. So the first thing we're going to want to do is sort those values to put them in order. And so we want to highlight that column that contains our data. And I'm going to look for the sort function under the data tab here. I'm going to choose sort. And I'm going to sort column A, smallest to largest. And now they've been reordered in order. This is going to make it easier for us to count the frequencies in this frequency table. So we have class limits already determined. These are whole number values, 0 through 9, 10 through 19, 20 through 29, and so on. Since we have all whole number values, we don't have to worry about values like 9.5 or 19.9. And so on. So we just want to count how many are in the 0 to 9 class, and we can do that by highlighting. And if we look down into the lower part of our screen here, we can see we've got a count of the number of things highlighted is 2, and so we can fill that in manually that way, or we could use a count function. So if I use the count formula, I can type equals count and just highlight the range of values that are applicable, and that count function will just simply count how many cells we highlighted to. I'm going to use that same function for the next class, values from 10 to 19. I'm just going to highlight then the ones that I want to count using that count function. Values from 10 up through 19, using that count function, there are 6 of them. I'm going to count the values in the 20 to 29 bin, highlighting them, closing that parenthesis, and we've got 12 of those in the 30 to 39 range. Same thing, highlighting the applicable values from 30 to 39, and then 40 to 49. Would be these here. And I can see I've got just one value in that final class. I could type that manually in as one value. So now we've got our frequencies, and we really did that more or less manually. We used Excel to just kind of help us with the counting, and most importantly, to sort the data into an ordered list so that that counting would be easy. Now, if we want to add up all of these frequencies, we can do that using a sum function. I type the formula equals sum, S-U-M, open parenthesis, highlight the range of values that we now want to add up, close that parenthesis, adds up to 40. So let's remember that the sum of frequencies in a frequency table should always be equal to the sample size. So that's kind of in part just a check to make sure we didn't miss anything. Adds up to 40. We didn't over or undercount anything. Got the right total. What about relative frequencies? Okay, relative frequencies would be percentages out of the whole. So 2 out of 40, 6 out of 40, 12 out of 40, and so on. So we can do that using a formula to calculate the percentage for us. It's going to be equal to this value here, and I'm going to click on it. So instead of typing a 2, I'll click on that cell that contains the value 2. All of our fractions are going to have the same denominator, so I'll divide by 40 every time, and I'm just going to hard code that 40 into my formula, and I'm going to calculate D2 divided by 40. This is coming out formatted as a percent because I already formatted that cell in percent format using this shortcut up here on the toolbar. If you're haven't formatted as a percent, it would show up as a decimal 0.05, the decimal form of 5%. Now, if we entered that as a formula D2 divided by 40, I can copy that and paste it into these remaining cells, and the formula will be adjusted to fit the format, the frequency divided by the total 40, and we'll get each percentage that way. We're going to use just the first simple default paste option, or Control V on your keyboard. And as a check, we can add up those values. And it should add up to 100%. The sum of relative frequencies should add up to the decimal number 1, or in percent form, 100%. So now we've got a completed frequency table and relative frequency table. Now I want to create a histogram. So for the histogram, we either create a frequency histogram or a relative frequency histogram. We're going to do a frequency histogram, which means the data that we really want to plot is the 2, 6, 12, 14, 5, and 1. These limits, class limits that we have typed out over here, are what we want to see as our horizontal axis labels. If I highlight just the data itself that I want plotted, okay, not trying to highlight everything in the table, but just these actual frequencies themselves that I want plotted, highlight those, go to Insert, and I will take the first, simplest, default bar graph option. Excel here is calling it a clustered column. And we get this visual display. As it appears now, it is not quite what we need to represent a histogram, but it's plotted each of these frequencies correctly. There's several deficiencies with this chart that make it so far an incomplete or incorrect graph as a histogram. Number one, a histogram for continuous quantitative data such as we have here, it cannot have these gaps between the bars. Secondly, the axis labels need to correspond to our class limits. These default labels 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 are not correct. The chart title needs to be changed to a descriptive title, or in some cases just removed, but it should never remain as this default placeholder chart title. And we may want horizontal and vertical axis labels. So let's take one thing at a time. I want to add those horizontal category labels. I'm going to do that by right-clicking for a context menu on one of the bars, and I'm going to choose the option to select data. Okay, and that's going to give me this dialog that has the fine level of control over what's actually plotted in there. And the thing that I want to change right now is the horizontal category axis labels. You can see the default that was showing up there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm going to edit that. And when I click Edit, I get another dialog, and I'm going to come in and I'm going to highlight what I want to appear as my class labels. I'm going to say OK and OK. And now I've got a reasonably correct set of horizontal axis labels there corresponding to the class limits we used. I don't like that chart title, I'm going to delete that. Now, I want to get rid of this gaps between these bars. And so I want to find Excel's option for the gap width, and I want to set it to 0. So again, I'm going to right-click on one of the bars for a context menu here. And now I'm going to choose Format Data Series. And this has brought up a dialog that includes the gap width, and that's the space between the bars, and I want to slam that down to 0. And now we've turned Excel's bar graph into something that looks much more like a proper histogram for a statistical display. If we had known information about what the variable was representing, we could add that label here as a horizontal axis label. Here, this problem was given with no context, so I don't really have a horizontal axis label to put on there, but the vertical axis label for this type of frequency label table or histogram can be frequency. So our vertical axis label can get that title frequency. Another adjustment that we may care to make is to just outline these bars to give them better definition. You could do that by again right-clicking on a bar to bring up that context menu and just format that outline. I'm going to give it a black colored outline. The default line weight looks fine, and now this to my eye is a reasonable histogram. If we had the information, a horizontal axis label saying what this represented, like weight in pounds or whatever it might represent, we could do that. If we had the context that allowed us to give it a proper title, we could do that as well. But we've hit all of the kind of minimum requirements, okay, for producing this kind of frequency table and histogram in Excel.